ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सहवीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः ॐ पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मने मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये शान्तिमन्त्र ॐ आप्यायन्तु ममाङ्गानि वाक् प्राणश्चक्षुश्रोत्रमथो बलमिन्द्रियाणि च सर्वाणि सर्वं ब्रह्मोपनिषदम् माहं ब्रह्म निराकुर्याम् मामा ब्रह्म निराकरोद् अनिराकरणमस्त्वनिराकरणं मे अस्तु तदात्मनिरते य उपनिषत्सु धर्माः ते मयि सन्तु ते मयि सन्तु ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः पेज नंबर 8 वायुर्भावसंवर्गः यदा वै अग्निः उद्वायते वायुमेव अप्येते यदा सूर्यः अस्तमेति वायुमेव अप्येते यदा चन्द्रः अस्तमेति वायुमेवाप्येति वायुर्भावसंवर्गः सो नाउ द टीचर सेज रैक्वा गिव इंस्ट्रक्शन टु हु जानश्रुति When now the right condition for imparting the teaching is established, the student having the right attitude, which is Shraddha, which is humility, which is surrender. So surrender is not something, it's like a slavery. It's something that comes from within you, that you just feel like, you know, bowing down to somebody. So when that happens, then the teacher now finds that the student has the right frame of mind. The idea is that whenever you communicate to somebody, that somebody should have the right frame of mind to grasp what it is that you are conveying. Not only while imparting the teaching, in our normal communication also, that the person who we are communicating with, our communication will become successful provided the person is in the right frame of mind, in the frame of receiving what we are saying, not resisting, not rejecting, not being indifferent, not ignoring. It can happen. People don't listen to you. They ignore you. They resist you. In which case, communication doesn't take place. Or what we say can be misinterpreted. So misinterpretations, wrong interpretations very often happen. Misunderstanding also arises when that right disposition that is required for communication is not there. So Swami used to say, I'm angry. We'll talk later. You see? I'm angry, meaning that right now I don't have the right disposition of mind to really communicate. So we'll talk later, meaning when I get that disposition of mind where I'm objective, I'm not saying something out of hatred or whatever, you know, then we'll communicate. So every moment this is required when we communicate. And when it is not there, misunderstandings can happen. What do you say can be misconstrued. And so, when the teacher is teaching also, the listeners also should have the right frame of mind. Therefore, the teacher places them at comfort. That they should all feel that we are all right, we are accepted, you know. Oh, Swami, I don't know Sanskrit, I don't know. So people have lots of complexes naturally. And they feel that the teacher here is the person who demands that I should know this, I should know that, I should this quality, etc. That I may feel unaccepted, not comfortable. Everybody is fine as they are. And you also take them into account when you communicate. So it's not too hi-fi, too scholarly, or, you know, and which people may not be able to relate to. At the same time, not that you water down, it's not compromising the profundity of the thing, understand? You never do not compromise the profundity of the teaching. But profundity need not necessarily be associated with certain language, etc. It can be simple. Swami used to say, I'm simple but profound. So, simplicity, so that people are also at ease and communication takes place in an easy atmosphere. There's no tension, no stress. At the same time, there is no compromise in the profundity. All I am saying is that for every communication, it is necessary that the right kind of atmosphere is there, right disposition is there, right relationship is there. And particularly for this communication of Brahma Vidya, when any ordinary communication also requires this, for that communication to successfully take place, what to talk about this communication for it to take successfully? It is not for no reason that they say that there should be Shraddha. That the students wrote Shraddha in the words of the teacher, in the words of the scriptures. It is not, that you want to control the people. It's not so. Shraddha is a disposition of mind wherein your mind is open and receptive, both open and receptive. It is respectful. That doesn't mean it is a slave. Surrender doesn't mean that I am a slave of somebody. If surrender comes as a result of some demand or some, then it's not a real surrender. It should happen from within me. I just feel like bowing down, suppose, you know. So somebody told me in the US, Swamiji, my two daughters, they don't bow down to anybody. But when Pujya Swamiji came, they themselves bow down. So that would be, so surrender is not something that is forced upon us. Something that happens. So when all this is there, then the student has the right disposition, and of course the teacher should have the right disposition. He should be kind, and he should be... He is testing in the olden days, they used to test the students to see and then where they are and to prepare them if necessary. But otherwise, it's all in kind, and you know, kindness is there, concern is there. So when that happened, then the teacher said, Vayurvavasam. Now the student is ready to understand what is going to be communicated. Some very profound, subtle principle about creation is being communicated. Samvargaha means place of merger, something that in fact swallows and makes it one with itself. So Vayurvava Samvargaha. Vayu is Samvarga. Vayu is air, possesses the quality of Samvarga, of merger, that things merge into Vayu, that Vayu makes them one with itself. Explains, Yadavai Agni Udvahayate, when the fire goes out, fire is extinguished, then it merges into air. And so also, Surya hai, Chandra hai, Sun, Moon, Apa hai, water. When water gets dried up, then also it merges into air. Because what remains? You see, when one thing disappears from sight, and other thing continues to remain in sight, then you say that this has merged into that. For example, water, fire was there and air was there. Now fire is not there and air is there. So you say that fire has merged into air. Water was there and air was there. Now water is dried up. Air remained, so water is merged into air. Sun was there, air was there. Sun has gone out of sight. Air is still there. Sun is merged into air, moon is merged into air. Meaning that we need not necessarily have to apply every little logical explanation for everything. Sometimes something is logical, sometimes it, okay, yeah, it's disappeared, has gone into Vayu. And then at the individual level also, so this is the at the cosmic level, the divine plane, you can say, Adhidaivatam. A similar phenomenon also happens at the individual level. The text says that prana vava samvargaha, this is air, which is a cosmic breath. Air is said to be cosmic breath, is breath of Ishvara, whereas prana is a individual breath. So what happens in the cosmos also happens here. That way is shown here, a correspondence between the cosmos and the individual. The oneness also, yatha pinde tatha brahmande, meaning what is in the individual is also in the universe. Sashchayam puruṣe yaschāsāvādityē sa ekaha. What is in this purusha, the individual, yaschāsāvādityē, in the sun, in the total, sa ekaha. All along this is a theme of showing the oneness between the individual and the total. How can it be when the size does not matter? The size matter, individual, I'm insignificant, I'm totally so vast, how can there be oneness? How can there be oneness between a drop of water and ocean? Cannot be. But in a way there is, because both are water. So yes, we accept the differences that are there, the name and level of name and form. But recognize that that's not the ultimate reality. So there is also something common, something samana, something one, which also we appreciate. Not to become proud, but to have a self-worth that I am all right, you know, what is there in the cosmos also is in me. Not only that, but what is in me is in cosmos is in me, what is in cosmos is in you, me who are between you and I also, there should be no comparison, otherwise you are superior, I mean, all these complexes are there because we are compared, but what is in the cosmos is in each one of us. So thus when you go to sleep, the Upanishad says, Yada svapedi pranamya vak apyedi. The speech merges into prana. How do you say that? Because when we are awake, prana, breath is also there and speech also is there. When you go to sleep, speech is no more there and breath is there. So speech has gone into breath. You follow? It's as simple as that. Arguments are really speaking. Only effect can merge into cause, theoretically. Theoretically, effect such as a part only can merge into cause, which is clay. And this prana is not the cause of the speech, etc. How can it be? But this is simple rule. The speech was there, prana also was there. Speech is not there, prana is there. So speech has merged into prana. So also, pranam chakshuhu, the faculty of seeing also is merged into prana when you go to sleep. Pranam shrotram, the faculty of hearing also has merged into prana. Manaha, pranam manaha, the mind also has merged into prana. So, Prahyeva edan sarvan samvrungtede. So just as at the cosmic level, it is the total air that really becomes a place of merger for all the devatas, and four are mentioned. Four devatas are mentioned in the divine plane, the sun and the moon, the fire and the water. And four are mentioned individual plane, vak, chakshuhu, shrotram, manaha. The speech, the eyes, the ears, the mind. Tavayato dvau samvargau vayureva deveshu pranah praneshu. Thus there are two places of merger. At the cosmic level, the vayu is a place of merger. At the individual level, the prana is a place of merger. So this is the meditation. So meditate and focus your attention on the vayu. And which aspect of vayu? The samvarga. How vayu is the swallower of everything. How vayu makes everything one with itself. How the vayu is a place of merger. So swallowing. So creation also is a reality of life, sustenance also, and samhara, destruction is equally a reality of life. So there is a sutra, atta characharasya, describing Ishvara. Who is Ishvara? Atta, he is a eater, he is a consumer, swallower of characharasya, the entire universe. Charam and acharam, sentient and insentient of the entire universe, Ishvara is a swallower. Yasya brahma cha kshatram cha ubhe bhavata odanaha mrityur yasya upasechanam. mantra that comes from Kathopanishad, where the teacher says, yasya brahmacha kshatramcha ube bhavata odanaha. Yasya for whom? For which Ishvara? Brahmacha kshatramcha. Brahma means Brahma. Kshatriya means the entire universe. So universe represented by Brahman Kshatriya is Odanam, is a rice for whom? You know, you see the people eating rice? In South India they mainly eat rice. The Vedic people also must be South Indians, because rice is the primary thing mentioned there also. Our Swami Shuddhanji used to describe, you know, in the past. You know, Swamiji in Andhra Pradesh, your rice in the plate is a whole heap of rice, and a hill of rice, you can say, not even a heap. Sufficient ghee is there, of course. Then, very, you know, the red chili, you know, pickle. Pickle red, hot. Mango pickle. You take that and mix it. Make it red. So in that rice, there is this pickle and ghee also, you know. And then you make balls out of them. You don't need to chew them, they just go straight. You already done mastication outside, you know. But to consume that rice, you require some pickle. So that is the, that's what I guess invokes your hunger, your appetite, and your taste buds, and the secretion of the, you know, so, saliva. So also when Ishvara consumes the whole universe, everything is rice. Ishvara also requires some pickle, some mrityu. Mrityu yasya upasejanam. Upasejanam means pickle or a chutney. What happens is when you consume rice, the pickle also gets consumed. You follow? No separate attempt required to consume pickle, isn't it? Similarly also when Ishvara consumes the universe, the mrityu, the kala, is also, time also is consumed. And so Kala Agni Rudra, so one who also is a swallower of Kala, swallower of time. Kalo Jagat Bhakshaka, Kala, the time consumes everything, but then one who consumes the time also? Atta Characharasya, is Atta. That's Ishvara is presented as Atta, as an eater, as a consumer. One who digests everything. Chara charam. Normally what you cannot, he eats all this stuff. Everything is. So this is the attribute of Ishvara, which is presented here for meditation. And this vayu or the cosmic air demonstrates how everything merges into that. So you meditate upon vayu as possessed of the attribute of swallowing everything, merging everything, being in the place of merger. When you meditate on yourself and meditate on your breath, on prana, as to how that is the place of merger of your whole personality. Then slowly vayu, depending on how the meditation vayu goes away, what remains is merger, consuming, atta, eating, consuming. And that is Ishvara. So that's how you meditate upon Ishvara with this attribute. And the meditation can go to the extent that you can become one with it. So to demonstrate how this meditation is, in the Upanishad, a story is being told. It's called Arthavada. Arthavada means a story which praises this meditation. So it says here, Atha Shaunakam Ka, once upon a time, at some point, once upon a time, Shaunakam Kapeyam abhipratayam cha kakshasainim parivishyamanau. Once upon a time, when these two sages or brahmanas, when is shaunaga kapeya, that is abhipratayi kakshasaini, names too, parivishyamanau, when they were being served with food, brahmachari vivikshe e brahmachari ke. Brahmachari means a student, one who follows brahmacharya, the student of studying Vedas, reciting Vedas, observing celibacy, also performing penance. So once upon a time, a brahmachari came along when these two brahmanas were being served the food. Vivikshe, that brahmachari asked for food. So when that happened, then these two persons looked at him. So brahmacharinaha, brahmin manitam buddha. Someone looking at his body language, what is facial expressions of this brahmachari? These two brahmanas concluded that, I think this fellow is making more show than what he really is. That he has some kind of a notion about himself, that I am eminent among all the brahmacharis, knowers of Brahma. So then brahmachari also is one who is devoted to the study of Brahma, Vedas, and Brahma also means Ishvara. So these two brahmanas concluded that I think this fellow is a little fake. He is asking for bhiksha. If it's real brahmachari, you are obliged to give bhiksha. But if not a real brahmachari, we'll see. Let us see. So tasmaiva na dadatuhu. Therefore, in order to, you know, find out how this fellow is, they did not give him the bhiksha. So hovacha, then brahmachari confronted these two brahmanas. Then he described who he is. Who am I? Brahmachari described who I am. He says, I am Hiranyagarbha. Meaning this brahmachari himself was a man of penance, performing meditations, and also realized this vayu, this samvarga. Meaning he happened to be an upasaka of, these two fellows were also. They did not about the brahmachari, but brahmachari also was an upasaka, meditator upon samvarga, the consumer. And he meditated to such an extent that he got identified with the cosmic consumer. So Ishvara is a consumer. Hiranyagarbha Sutra Atma, who consumes everything. The one who generates also consumes, you know. One who gives birth, meaning the one that is the cause of creation, is cause of sustenance, is also the cause of merger, is it not so? Like the clay is the cause of the giving birth to the parts, sustaining the parts, and clay is the place of merger of all the parts also. So brahmachari was meditating upon and had realized the identity with this devata, the cosmic devata. So he describes who he is. Sahovacha, mahatmana chaturaha devaha ekaha kaha sa jagara bhuvanasya gopaha. There is one deva, one self-effulgent deity, kaha. Kaha means Brahma. Kam Brahma. Kaha means Brahma, Prajapati, the creator. He's also the swallower. Chaturaha Mahatmanaha Jagara. This Prajapati swallowed these four great ones. Who are the great ones? Who are swallowed? Yada Agni Udvayati Vayam Eva Pyeti. When the fire goes out, it merges into air. The sun merges into air. When the sun sets, merges into air. The moon sets, merges into air. When the water dries up, merges into the four, isn't it? The four great ones. Sun and the moon and fire are not ordinary entities, they are powerful entities. So Chaturaha Mahatmana, these four great ones. Chavara, he swallowed them, Vayu, cosmic Vayu, called Sutratma. Bhunasya Gopaha, he is a creator of the universe also, therefore protector of the universe also, and the concealer of the universe also. Tam kāpeya na vipashyanti martyaha. He kāpeya, addressing one of the brahmanas. He vipritāren, addressing the two. Tam martyaha na this devata, martyaha, the mortal. Who are the mortal people? Who is a mortal person, you know? One who is subject to death, right? It's called mortal. What is subject to death? Really, what is subject to death? The body. So we, huh? Born, but what is born? Body. Then who is mortal? Then who is mortal? The one identified with the body. Body doesn't think I am mortal. I think I am mortal, meaning one. So martyaha. Those identified with the body, they do not know, meaning they have not grown beyond this. In order for you to know this, you give up the identification. One body and identify with the cosmos, that is when you know it, you follow. This is the meditation. All spiritual practices are meant to slowly de-identify from the individuality and identify with. We thought that totality is a huge thing, but slowly stretching the ego, identifying with great, so include, becoming inclusive. All spiritual practices are to become inclusive. So whenever Swami would say, transform yourself from being consumer to a contributor. What does it mean? When you contribute to somebody, that means that you include them also. You don't lead. You also share with them, isn't it? That's called being a contributor. So you include them also in your life, in you. Meaning that you don't really stand for this little one, but then you also take them also into account, meaning that you stretch yourself. So consumer means what? Contributor means what? One who includes others. One therefore stretches the ego to include others. Yes, that is when really thing begins, otherwise there is no spirituality. Meaning that we perform virtuous actions all right, as long as I perform with a full desire to fulfill, then I only include myself. Even when a virtuous action I perform, like charity, like all kinds of things I do, which is good to do, which earns me punya. But as long as only beneficiary through that is myself, so long I not included anybody, isn't it? So as long as I only include myself in my life, so long the spiritual life has not begun. Religious life is one thing. Spiritual life is a little different. Religious, yes. Yajna, dana, tapaha, worship is there, charity is there, austerity is there, all these things are there. What is the purpose? I want to gain this, I want to whatever. Phalam uddishyava punaha. So when phalam is there, then that becomes a rajasic thing. But when you do something, anupakarana, when something is given without any expectation of a return in the favor, that's called sattvic dhanam. That is when the spirituality begins. Mean the real growth begins. That's what we mean. When Pujya Swami talks about emotional maturity, emotional growth, that begins when we start including others. How far can you go? Such that you include the whole universe. That's a tall order. It's a big deal. But this is what is prescribed here. Then you can grow that much by identifying. You identify with Vayu, the Samvarga, the place of merger. And ultimately, who are you? The one who... So that, as we said yesterday, that Vayu exhibits the quality of swallowing that comes from what? Comes from Ishvara, is it not so? Yesterday we told the story from Keno Upanishad that Vayu was Ambar, Agni was Ambar, because Vayu, fire could not burn even a blade of grass, or air could not blow even a blade of grass, which means that the ability on the part of Agni or fire to burn comes from Ishvara. Fire thought that I am burning, really I am not burning. Somebody is burning through me. So ultimately, even the Vayu also has the capacity to swallow, that comes from Ishvara. So it is Ishvara's quality. You are meditating, Vayu becomes a nimitta, becomes a symbol or a place where you meditate upon Ishvara, possessed with the quality of samvarga or merger, swallowing. So the Brahmachari said that here is Kaha. Kaha means Brahma, means Prajapati, means the creator. So, Bhuvanasya Govan is the protector of the universe and also swallower of the universe. Chaturaha Mahatmanaha Jagara. He swallowed these four great entities, the sun and the moon, the fire and the water. Tam Martyaha Navipas. But those who are mortal, meaning identify the body, they do not see him. They don't see, they don't experience him. For seeing him, you slowly grow out of the identification with one individuality, established with the totality. So first step is Karma Yoga, second step is Upasana. Karma Yoga also is our attempt. Yoga means the spirit of contribution. If you say that means what? Merging or slowly becoming free from the identification. Bahudha Vasantam. And that Devata appears many ways. At the cosmic level as Vayu, at the individual level as Prana, and so this manifests in at the Adhidevika level, at the Bhautika level, Adhyatmika level. Yasmeva Edrandam. You know you are cooking food for whom? You prepare, make preparation for cooking and cook the food for whom? For the Vaishvanara, for the one who digests the food, isn't it? Who is that Vaishvanara? He is that cosmic consumer. Who consumes the food? When you eat the food, there is a consumer inside, is it not? Who is that? The stomach fire, the digestive fire. So he says that, in fact, this Devata, the cosmic consumer, alone obtains as a consumer in the individual stomach. Aham Vaishvanara Bhutva Pranayanam Deham Ashtita. So understand that Devata, the consumer, the Samvarga, obtains in various ways at the individual level, elemental level, cosmic level. So you are cooking food for him. Do you realize? When you cook food for, then you cook for whom? For yourself means what? For the Jatharagni means what? For the consumer, for the one who eats, consumes. Who is that? Is that same Vaishvanara, Devata? A Brahmins, the one for whom you are preparing, cooking food, to him you are not given the food. So when you deny me the food, you deny whom? Who am I? I am that Vaishvanara. I am that Prajapati. I am the cosmic consumer. Meaning that is my realization. That's my upasana. That's who I am. You see only a body, but who am I? You are what your mind is ultimately. So idea is that you are the becoming at the level of mind ultimately, that's what you become when you depart from this body. So you already are in this body. It's not that after departing the body you become something. Here itself you have become that. And you depart. So already Brahmacharya, I am this. So when you denied me the food, you denied food to the one for whom you are cooking the food in the first place. You understand that? Then this fellow has realized who he is. Hey, what a way of answering. By answering this question this way, he reveals the nature of upasana and what he has realized. Now let's see how these two fellows respond. Tado shaunakah kapeyah pratimanvanah. This Shaunaka, this one of the Brahmanas, then he deliberated upon this. Pratyaya, then he approved. I have deliberated. What is this talking? What does he mean? Then this Shaunaka, Kapya, realized what he means. And then he told him, who am I? He says then. He says, Atma Devanam Janita Prajanam. There is a Devata who is Devana, who is the self of all the Devatas. Janita Prajanam, who is the Janita, the progenitor of all the beings. Hiranyadamstraha. He has the golden teeth. This one. He is describing the Atta, the consumer. Samvarga means the consumer. Who is the consumer? Ultimately, Atma Devanam, who is the self of all the Devatas, Janita Prajanam, progenitor of all the beings, the Prajapati, the creator. Hiranyadamstraha, when it's golden teeth. And so what it means is that gold here stands for something that never loses shine, that ever is, meaning that he is one who is with whose teeth never breaks, with unbroken teeth. You know what it means? We start losing teeth as we grow old. See, when you study Taittiriya Upanishad, you'll come across the definition of annam. What is annam? Means food. Adyate ticha bhutani. That which is eaten and that which eats. So when we eat the food, we think we eat, but food also is eating us by slowly wearing us out. The body also slowly gets worn, the teeth also get worn out. And they fall. So we are eaters, all right. But what kind of eaters we are? We are also being eaten, understand? Adyate tisa bhutani. That is called food which is eaten at the same time which eats. So we are eaters, but we are eaten also. But here we are talking, eater is not eaten. You follow? So Hiranyadamstraha, with unbroken teeth, golden teeth, immortal teeth, meaning that is only eater, not eaten. Bhavasaha, bhakshanashilaha, to consume or eat is his nature, his eater. And what is he? Is he some kind of animal or anasurihi? No. He is surihi. He is intelligent. So he is divine. He is a conscious being, intelligent. Mahantamasya mahimanam ahuhu. They say that the glory of this devata, who is the consumer, is great is his glory. What is his glory? Anadyamanah yad annamattiti. Anadyamanah, one who is not eaten, who eats everything. What? Anannamatti. One who is not eaten, who cannot be eaten, eats non-eatable things. You know, this moon is, sun is not an eatable thing. Is it an eatable thing? Moon, is it an eatable thing? Fire is an eatable thing? So he eats uneatable. himself uneaten, and eats also all uneatable also. He consumes, being not being consumed, he consumes everything. That's his glory. Vayam brahmacharin idam sahi brahmachari. We are meditating upon this devata. So same devata is described in a different way. So these two passages are singing the glories of the devata samvarga who we are meditating upon. So when they prescribe meditation, they also describe the glory of who you are meditating, who you are going to meditate upon. So thus these two pages describe the glory of that Hiranyagarbha or the cosmic consumer. So these two Brahmanas say that we are meditating on him, meaning we are no less than you. But recognize that he also is like us. He says, Dattasmayan Bhikshamede, hey, give him the Bhiksha. So that's how the Bhiksha. So this is an anecdote. The episode that is described here, to sing the glory of the devata upon whom one is to meditate, and what are the results of that meditation also. And this episode tells us that somebody did meditate. I mean, it's not just that it's only in the books. There was a brahmachari, there were these two brahmanas, and this conversation took place between them, meaning that this meditation had been performed, and then therefore those realization on the part of those who meditated. Tasmavad daduhu, then the bhiksha was given to that brahmachari. Then remember this example of the Krutaya, Vijitaya in the game of dice. That dice having four dots called Kruta. Having three dots is called Treta. Two dots is called Dvapara. And one dot is called Kali. Now, 1, 2, 3, 4, right? So 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 is what? 10. So remember all these numbers which came earlier. So how this the example that was given, how that example enables us to see again some harmony, something that is there in the universe. So it says, Ede panch anye panch anye. Dasa santaha tat kritam bhavati. There are these five. Who are the five? You remember? Yada vai agnihi udvahati vayam eva pyati. So fire merges into vayu, sun merges into vayu, moon merges into vayu, water merges into vayu. So how many are there? How many? Four and one, five. Vayu is one in whom everything merges. So Vayu is Atta, the eater. Those fellows are eaten. Together they become five. So Panch Anye, there is one group of five at this cosmic level. Panch Anye, at the individual level also. So here who is Atta? Pranaha. And what? Who are the eaten? Vak, Chakshuhu, Shrotram, Manaha. So five at the cosmic plane, five at the individual plane. So five and five becomes 10. Oh, what a revelation. Huh? Tat krutam bhavati. That becomes krutam. You know that dice called krutam? What is that dice? Krutam. That also is 10. Because it is 4, which includes 3, which belong to Treta. It also includes 2, which belong to Dvapara. It also includes 1, belongs to Kali. So this solo becomes what? 4 plus 3 plus 2 plus 1, how much is that? 10. So Kruta also is 10, and the Devata are also 10, you follow? Now, how many directions are there? How many quarters are there? How many directions are, quarters are there? North, south, east, west, then what? Corners. North east, northwest, southeast, southwest. Makes it what? 8. Above, below, makes it what? Dasha disha. So, look at the quarters are also how many? 10. See this? Now, thus this number 10 is presented as an alambana for meditation. Sarva sudikshu annameva dasha krutam sayasha virat annadi. So, thus, because of the number 10, dasha krutam, this kruta, the dice is also 10. The directions also are 10. There is a fourth thing that is also 10. There is Virat. This Virat, or Virat means cosmic person. You know Virat Purusha. But Virat also is never a meter. You know Gayatri was a meter. How many letters were there in Gayatri? 24. Anushtu, how many letters are there? 32. So, also the meter called Virat. How many? There are 10 letters in that meter. So, Virat means also the cosmic person also has association with 10, that it is the meter having 10 letters. So, 10 devatas are there. That Kruta also is 10 because the 10 directions are there, and this meter called Virat also is 10. Therefore, sa virat dasa sankhya sati annam cha annadyam. See, this 10 includes both annam and annadya. The food and the eater both are included, you follow? In the fire, the wife is the eater. And Surya, Chandra, Agni, Apaha, the food. So, Atta is eater, Annam is food. At the individual plane, Prana is the eater, and Vak, Chakshuhu, Shrotram, Manaha, they are the food. So, this 10 is what? Combination of eater as well as eaten. So, annadi annadini cha krutatvena, and therefore this virat, this devata is what? Food as well as the eater of the food. Tatha vidvan dasa devata atma bhuta asan viratvena. So, therefore this vidvan or the meditator, when he meditates upon this samvarga, this place of merger, which includes the 10 entities, 4 devatas that are food, and the 5th devata that is the eater. Or the 4 organs, you know, which are food, and the 5th prana which is eaten. So, because of that identification number 10, he also becomes Virat, which is also 10, and there becomes what? The food and the eater of food. Thus, he identifies the cosmic eater and cosmic food. Annannadiniya. So, this is what we meditate upon, the anna annadini, the food as well as the eater of the food. So, one who becomes that, so one who meditates upon that also becomes what? A great annam annadaha. So, becomes, so number one gets identified with Virat Devata, which is Suhri number 10. And since Virat is both the food and eater of food, he also becomes eater of food. So, thus, this is concluded by saying that, thus when you meditate, so for meditation we require some kind of an alambana, some similarity is required. Therefore, it is a very strange way of giving similarities. one way is the consumer, and other way is all this, the number 10. Because the example was given that krutaya vijitaya athareyaha. So when you get that kruta, then all the lower, the athara, all the dice of the lower dots automatically get included. So kruta includes everything, and kruta is 10. So 10 includes everything. So 10 devatas are there, 10 individual entities are there, the virat also is 10. So one who meditates this way also becomes identified with virat. And in the day-to-day life, he becomes eater of food. Somehow, all along in the Vedas, this is mentioned very often. Annavan annado bhavati. Annavan bhavati, annadah bhavati. Meaning he becomes possessor of plenty of food and he becomes eater of food, means he gets good appetite also. Because merely blessing somebody that may have plenty of food with no appetite would not help. And blessing somebody may have a great appetite and no food, that also won't help. So bless him both ways. Otherwise they say that I did not have the groundnut when I had teeth. When I had teeth, I didn't have anything to chew. You know, the mungfali groundnut, something that you enjoy eating. Now that I have those things, I don't have teeth, unfortunately. So nuts I have. When I had teeth, I had no nuts. Now that I have nuts, there are no teeth. So you need both. You need teeth also, as well as nuts also. Annavan annado bhavati. Therefore, he becomes possessed of plenty of food and also a great consumer of food. All of this I say just to sort of give you an idea of how the Upanishads convey this idea of how different kinds of arambanas or support or the pratika, the symbols are given based on some similarities to help us meditate from what is profane to what is profound. So this kruta, this is something, you know, profane. The dice to the virat, that's the profound. So thus, how we can use this one number 10 and jump, not jump, but quantum jump from the simple number 10, which is this four dice, to the cosmic, which is virat. And so meditation is on virat, but for that you need something, some handle. Alambaram, you need that pole. So this number 10 becomes a pole which helps you, you know, to rise from identifying with this one individual body to ultimately become virat, identifying the totality. Okay, good, we'll continue in next class. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavasishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam Sutra Bhashya Krutau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah. Ishvaro Guru Ratmedi Bhagine Vyoma Vadvyapta Dehaya Dakshina Murtaye Namah. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Hari Om Shri.